Hello everyone, this is another week of the Major Literary Works in English Literature series, and today I have chosen the work written by George Eliot entitled Middlemarch. Middlemarch is considered by many critics as George Eliot's best depiction of provincial English town life during the Victorian age. At least 50 characters, some good and some bad, weave in and out of the author's narrative. The novel is composed of two stories. In one story, Dorothea Brooke, seeking a high purpose in life, marries an elderly clergyman with the thought of helping him in his life work. She finds that his appreciation of her services is very slight. She has become very disillusioned by the time her husband dies, some 2 years after the marriage. She also finds that he has restricted her future actions by certain provisions of his will. One particular provision forbids her to marry a young Will Ladislaw. The other story concerns Rosamond Vincey, a beautiful girl who is the daughter of the mayor of Middlemarch. She feels more refined than her family and marries young Dr. Lydgate in the hope of elevating herself. Since he is the nephew to a baronet, young Lydgate is poor, however, and struggles to make an honest living as a physician. Rosamond, disillusioned, proves to be more of a hindrance than help in the young doctor's struggle for success. George Eliot here has deliberately developed the ambitions of his two heroines for a moral purpose. She attempts to show that, although in both cases the purpose in entering marriage was a high-minded one, the circumstances were such as to bring the ladies to disillusionment. George Eliot believed in fate or destiny that guides selfish human motives to social disaster, and in none of her novels it is more evident than in Middlemarch. This novel, no doubt, is a lengthy one, but the kind of story it depicts, it is something that you all must read at least once. I hope this podcast was helpful to you. Please do like, share and subscribe to the channel, and see you next week with another major literary work in English literature. Stay home, be safe, take care.